Sara Duterte Carpio has decided to run for re-election as Davao City Mayor. Now, is this a final nail in the coffin for those urging her to run for president? Joining us now is the Secretary General of her regional party, Hukbong ng Pagbabago, former Davao del Sur Governor Anthony Del Rosario. Governor, good afternoon to you and thank you for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Carmina. Thank you for inviting.
All right, the last time we talked, Governor, you said you were still hopeful that come October, things might change. Maybe the president will withdraw from his vice presidential bid and this will open the door now for the mayor to gun for the presidency in the 2022 elections. And now with your announcement, where does that now leave all those hopes, Governor?
Well, as of the moment, Carmina, the mayor has already made up her mind. She has already decided that she will seek re-election and complete her 3 terms as mayor of Davao City. You know, but the decision, of course, was born by the fact that President Duterte had accepted the nomination for vice president coming from his party, PDP Laban. No? And of course, as we all know, the mayor has already said in several occasions that only Juan Duterte will run in the national elections in 2022. No? So I guess because of the nomination of PDP to President Duterte to run for vice president, the mayor finally decided to run for re-election.
Well, the certificates of candidacy, those have yet to be filed. If President Duterte decides not to make a go of it, will Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio still seek the presidency next year?
Again, we really don't know what would happen. Again, I think we will just have to wait and see once the president makes up his mind. No? If the president decides to consider his plans for 2022, then again, we will have to wait and see how Mayor Sara will respond to President Duterte's move. But in the meantime, since that is not what is happening, then we can therefore say that Mayor Sara will seek re-election.
Yeah, because she also has said that she's not a last-minute replacement. So is this something that was solidly decided on already by the mayor?
Well, we know, Carmina, that the filing for COC is from October 1 to October 8, no? So me as chairman of Hukbong Para Kay Sara, and of course together with our 10,000 members, we still believe that nothing is final until October 8th, which is the last day of filing. So we still have about 2-3 weeks left in the hope that we will be able to convince the president to reconsider his plans for 2022. No? And as I said, if and when it happens, then we will have to see how Mayor Sara will respond to that.
All right. So you were saying that you're still hopeful and you're still trying to convince the president. How actively are you convincing the president? And what exactly are you telling him so that he will consider or reconsider his vice presidential race, Governor?
Carmina, just a correction. No? We have not spoken yet to the president about our plans. No? As of the moment, we are still taking in more members into Hukbong Para Kay Sara, that is the citizens' movement which I chair. No, so right now the movement has already 10,000 members, and we're looking to expand the membership and hopefully reach 50,000 within the next 2 weeks. Once we have those numbers, then possibly we would like to talk to the president and hopefully convince him to reconsider his plans for 2022.
And tell him exactly what, Governor?
Well, basically that the people want his daughter to run for president, and there is really a sincere and genuine clamor for Mayor Sara to seek the presidency in 2022. And the only way that she can do this is if the president reconsiders his plans for 2022.
Why would it be more beneficial for Sarah to run as president over the president running as vice president, governor?
Because as president, if Sarah is the next president of this country, we want her to continue what the president has started, no? If the president runs for vice president, we're not really sure who will be the next president. So it's possible that the next president, assuming Sarah doesn't run, could be would be totally against what President Duterte has started. And that is not something that we want, no? We want continuity. And the people of this country, based on the surveys that we have been seeing, also want Sarah to continue what her father started.